An amazing Tuesday afternoon, everyone. Hello, Science 10 learners, teachers, and enthusiasts. I am Tutor Richard D. Vidal. You can call me Tutor Ichad from Catmon Integrated School, Schools Division Office of Malabon City. Welcome to our Itulay online tutorial on TV. Talaga namang hashtag Itulay Level Up. Dahil hindi lang tayo nagkikita-kita sa Facebook, YouTube at iba pang social media platforms ng Department of Education. Aba, nasa TV na rin tayo. So sit back, relax, and have your self-learning modules ready with you, our dear learners. So this is our Science 10 Quarter 2, Week 3. Ayan, so alam ko excited na kayong lahat. Ang lesson o topic natin ngayon ay practical applications and effects of electromagnetic waves, part 1. So unang bahagi pa lang ito ha. Particularly, this week, we are going to talk about radio waves, microwaves, infrared, and visible light. Ayan. So sa unang bahagi, marami na agad tayong pag-uusapan. Maraming salamat sa ating learning partners mula sa Bureau of Learning Resources or BLR at sa ating gagamiting self-learning module ng Department of Education Central Office na Alternative Delivery Mode or ADM. So pag-usapan naman natin our learners ang ating most essential learning competencies para sa quarter 2, week 3. Ayan. So una, yan, meron tayong dalawang most essential learning competencies. Ang una nating MELCs ay cite examples of practical applications of the different regions of electromagnetic waves such as the use of radio waves in telecommunication. Ang code ng ating unang MELCs ay S10FE-2C-D-48. At ang ikalawa naman nating most essential learning competency ay explain the effects of electromagnetic radiation on living things and the environment, na meron namang code na S10FE-2E-F-49. Ayan. So simulan na natin ang ating discussion ngayong hapon sa pamamagitan ng iba't ibang mga reminders na tinatawag nating what I need to know. Ayan. So una, take the pretest prepared at the end of the module. Take time in reading and understanding the lesson. Follow instructions carefully. Number two, use a clean sheet of paper for your answers in each activity or assessment. And number four, try to recall and connect the ideas that you had in the lower years. Ayan. So number five naman natin para sa ating mga reminders ay be honest. When doing the activities, record only what you have really observed. Number six, don't hesitate to ask. If you need to clarify something, approach or contact your teacher. Number seven, take the post-test prepared at the end of the module. And last but not the least, you can check your answers in the activities, self-assessments, and our post-test. So let's proceed to our What I Know part of our SLM. We have a multiple choice for this part, no, of our discussion this afternoon. So the directions of this multiple choice is read each question carefully, choose the letter of the correct answer, use a separate sheet of paper for your answers. So can you still remember the different forms of electromagnetic waves you have learned from the previous module? While all electromagnetic waves move through space at the same speed of about 300 million meters per second, as discussed by Sir Rainier last week, their wavelengths, frequencies, and energies differ. This is the reason why they are arranged accordingly in a scheme called electromagnetic spectrum. So let's compare the relative wavelengths, frequencies, and energies of different regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Question number one for our What I Know. What electromagnetic wave makes cellular telephones transmit and receive signals. A. Radio waves. B. Microwaves. C. Visible light. Or letter D, is it gamma rays? I'll count. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter B, microwaves, ikaw ay mahusay. Question number 2 for our what I know. All of the following are uses of visible light. Which one is not? Is it A, it enables us to see things? B, gives light to the screen of our devices? Letter C, for thermal imaging? Or letter D, used in optical fibers? I'll count. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay for thermal imaging, okay, mahusay. Ag-amazing ang iyong naging kasagutan. Question number 3 para sa ating what I know. Which kind of wave is used in night vision goggles? Is it letter A, microwave? Letter B, infrared? Letter C, gamma rays? Or letter D, visible light? I'll count again. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay infrared, ikaw ay scientific. Magaling. Question number 4 para sa ating what I know. Which of the following electromagnetic waves makes use of artificial lighting? Is it letter A, visible spectrum? Letter B, is it X-ray? Letter C, gamma rays? Or letter D, infrared? I'll count. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter A, visible spectrum, ikaw ay mahusay. Last question para sa ating what I know segment. Ang question number 5 natin ay ito. What type of electromagnetic waves is used in radar? Is it letter A, infrared? B, microwaves? Is it letter C, radio waves? Or letter D, ultraviolet rays? I'll count again. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter B o microwaves, ikaw ay scientific. Congratulations, Science 10 learners, for answering our what I know questions. Now, let's proceed to next part of our SLM. This is what's in. Narito ang ating directions. On a separate sheet, answer the following activity. Look at the picture on the next slide. Write the name of the correct electromagnetic wave corresponding to the letters on the picture. You may refer your answer for numbers 1 to 4 from the box. Are you ready? So, for our picture, this is what you need to see and to use inside our box. We have X-ray, radio wave, microwave, infrared, gamma ray, ultraviolet, and visible light. So let's answer question number 1. What is letter A? You have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo para sa letter A ay radio wave, ikaw ay mahusay. Question number 2. Letter B ang ating hinahanap. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay microwave, ikaw ay scientific. Question number 3 ay letter C ang hinahanap natin sa ating diagram na mahanap ang sagot sa loob ng box. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay infrared, ikaw ay mahusay. Number 4, question. Ang hinahanap naman ay ang letter D. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay visible light, ikaw ay sightastic. Ang huling tanong para sa ating what's in segment para sa inyong SLM. What letter shows the lowest frequency? You have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo para sa ating huling tanong ay letter A o tinatawag natin na radio wave, ikaw ay mahusay. Congratulations, Science 10 learners. Nasagutan mo lahat ng items para sa ating what's in. Ngayon, Science 10 learners, balikan natin ang mga science concepts na ating napag-aralan noong week 2 last week kasama ang ating tutor, Rainier De Jesus. Number 1, sabi doon, the electromagnetic spectrum is the arrangement of electromagnetic waves, which are waves that are created with changing electric field and magnetic field. Na-discuss last week na sa pamamagitan ng pag-aaral ng electric field at magnetic field, nabuo ang konsepto ng electromagnetic spectrum at electromagnetic waves. Number 2 sa napag-usapan, electromagnetic waves travel on vacuum at a constant speed of 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Ang bilis ng pag-travel ng electromagnetic waves sa free space or kahit anong vacuum ay mahihahalin tulad natin, no, sa speed of light. Sumunod rin na napag-usapan, number 3, the electromagnetic spectrum is arranged in a manner of decreasing wavelength, increasing frequency, and increasing energy. Number 4 sa ating quick recall na napag-usapan din. Radio wave has the lowest wavelength, longest wavelength, hindi lowest ha, longest wavelength, lowest frequency, and lowest energy among all electromagnetic waves. Number 5, the visible light is the only electromagnetic wave that can be seen by our naked eye, whereas red has the longest wavelength and violet has the greatest frequency. Ayan, so ituloy pa natin ang mga napag-usapan. Number 6, gamma ray has the shortest wavelength and the highest frequency, which carries the highest energy among all electromagnetic waves. At last naman, number 7. Sabi dyan, radio wave has the lowest ionizing radiation while gamma ray has the highest ionizing radiation. Now, let's proceed to what is its section of your self-learning modules. Pag-usapan natin ang mga practical applications ng ating mga electromagnetic waves. Simulan natin sa mga practical application examples ng ating radio waves. So ang nakikita niyo sa larawan ay ang radio or television signals. Radio and television signals are radio waves that are produced by making electrons vibrate. It has a long wavelength capable of transmitting sound and picture information over long distances. Ikalawang halimbawa ng practical na application, no, ng radio waves ay ang ating global positioning system or yung tinatawag nating GPS. GPS is a space-based navigation system that provides geographical position and time information anywhere on or near the Earth. It communicates with stations on the ground using radio waves. Isa din sa pinakamalaking ambag ng pag-aaral ng radio waves ay ang bahagi ng halimbawang paggamit dito sa GPS. Example din ng practical application para sa radio wave ang tinatawag nating magnetic resonance imaging or yung MRI. It is a medical imaging technique that uses powerful magnets, computer, and radio waves to make detailed pictures inside your body. isa sa pinakamalaking ambag din yan sa pag-aaral ng radio waves sa health innovation, ang MRI, na maaaring makadetect ng mga problema sa katawan ng tao at ng mga hayop. Pag-aralan naman natin ang practical application examples under microwaves. Una, ang satellite communication. Microwaves are used in satellite communications because it can penetrate the Earth's atmosphere. Microwave signals are transmitted by an antenna to a satellite, which amplifies and retransmits the signal to an antenna in other parts of the world. This is how we communicate even from afar. Okay, so yan yung ating halimbawa. Okay, unang halimbawa ng microwave application. Ikalawa naman na ating practical application ay ang tinatawag na terrestrial communication. A cell phone is a radio transmitter and receiver that uses microwaves. Cellular phones depend on overlapping network of cells. Each cell has its tower that receives and sends microwave signals. Ayan, naging posible ang pakikipagkomunikasyon sa ibang panig ng daigdig dahil sa teknolohiyang hatid ng microwaves. Sunod naman na practical application example ay maaaring gamitin ang microwave sa pagluluto o tinatawag nating cooking. The microwaves in a microwave oven penetrate and agitate the water molecules within the food. Thus, they create molecular friction which produces heat that will cook the food. Mas mabilis na ang pag-iinit ng pagkain kahit galing pa ito sa refrigerator dahil sa teknolohiya ng microwave kapag ginagamit ito sa pagluluto. At ang huli namang aplikasyon ng microwaves ay ang radar o tinatawag nating radio detection and ranging. It is a detection system used to determine the range, angle, or velocity of objects. It can be used to detect aircraft, ships, and the like. Nagagamit ang teknolohiya ng radar upang makita ang mga paparating na eroplano sa himpapawid at mga sasakyang pandagat. At syempre, sa marami pang pamamaraan. So I hope may natutunan na kayo mula sa ating radio waves at microwaves. Tungo naman tayo sa ikatlo nating electromagnetic wave practical application. Simulan natin ulit sa infrared. Ang isa sa mga halimbawa ng practical application ng infrared ay ang paggamit natin ng remote control or IR remote, infrared remote ang tawag doon. It uses LED lights to transmit signals to control devices. It emits pulses of invisible infrared light. Ayan, so nakasentro sa remote na yan, no? Nagiging masarap ang panunood natin ng TV kung ginagamitan ng remote control. Ayan, so mas nagiging madali ang paglilipat natin ng ating channel sa mga paborito nating panuurin sa TV. Next, na practical application naman ng infrared ay yung tinatawag natin na thermal imaging through infrared scanners. Infrared scanners such as thermal imaging and thermal scanner are used to show the temperature variation of the body. Ayan. So sunod naman ang thermal imaging, no? Itong bahagi na yun ang pag-aaral ng thermal imaging gamit yung ganyang uri ng teknolohiya sa mga paliparan or sa airport kung saan mas madaling malaman ang temperatura ng mga umuuwing OFW galing sa ibang bansa. Kung sila ba ay nilalagnat or maaaring may nararamdamang masama sa kanilang katawan. Yan. Ang huli naman na practical application ng infrared ay ang paggamit rito sa tinatawag nating night vision goggles. Night vision goggles use thermal imaging technology to capture the infrared light being emitted as heat by objects in the field of view. Ang mga sundalo at mga hunters ang ilan sa mga gumagamit ng teknolohiya ng night vision goggles upang mas malinaw na makakita sa madilim o kaya kapag gabi. Ayan. Yan ang mga halimbawa ng practical applications ng infrared. Tungo naman tayo sa huling electromagnetic wave practical applications para sa visible light. Unang halimbawa ng practical application ng visible light ay ang artificial lights. Light, flashlight, lamp, etc. are any light source that produce light instead of natural lights produced by the sun. Iyan ang isa sa mga pinakahalimbawa no, na application ng ating pag-aaral na yan ng visible light. Isa pa, no, at ang huli sa halimbawa pa ng application ng visible light ay yung tinatawag natin na optical fibers. One use of optical fibers in medicine is endoscope, a flexible tube with tiny camera that is used to observe the internal parts of the body. So, ayan ang mga halimbawa ng ating visible lights. Congratulations! Napagtagumpayan mong malaman ang mga practical applications ng unang apat na electromagnetic waves mula sa radio waves hanggang sa visible light spectrum. Now, let's move to what I have learned. Ayan naman yung ating pag-uusapan. Ang ating directions para sa what I have learned, choose the correct term from the enclosed choices that should go into the blank spaces. Number one, radio or television signals, GPS, and MRI are practical applications of blank. Is it radio wave or microwave? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay radio wave, ikaw ay mahusay. Statement number 2. Satellite communication, cooking, terrestrial communication, and radar make use of blank. Is it infrared or microwave? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay microwave, ikaw ay sightastic. Statement number 3 para sa ating what I have learned. Remote controls, thermal imaging, and night vision goggles are practical applications of blank. Is it infrared or ultraviolet? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay infrared, ikaw ay mahusay. Statement number 4. You can see things around you because of blank. Is it gamma rays or visible light, which is also used in optical fibers, artificial lights, and screens of electronic devices? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay visible light, ikaw ay sightastic. Last question or statement, no? Yung nakita natin kanina. Magtungo naman tayo para sa ating assessment na muli ay multiple choice. Basahin natin ang directions. Read each question carefully. Choose the letter of the correct answer. Use a separate sheet of paper for your answers. Let's answer now the assessment part for question number 1. Radio wave is useful in which of the following applications? Is it A, watching television? B, treating cancers? C, sterilizing medical equipment? Or letter D, sunbathing? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter A or watching television, ikaw ay mahusay. Punta naman tayo para sa ating question number 2. Infrared waves is useful in which of the following applications? Is it A, remote control? B, television signal? C, screen of electronic devices? Or letter D, night vision goggles? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter A or remote control, ikaw ay sightastic. Question number 3 para sa ating assessment. Microwave is useful in which of the following applications? Is it letter A, remote control? B, cell phone communication? C, artificial lighting? Or letter D, is it sterilization? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter B o cellphone communication, ikaw ay mahusay. Question number 4 para pa rin sa ating assessment. Invisible light, which color has the longest wavelength? Is it letter A, red, B, violet, C, yellow, or letter D, green? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay letter A or red, ikaw ay saitastic. Para naman sa huling tanong ng ating assessment, which of the following is not an application of visible light? Is it letter A, bulb? B, security markings? C, cellphone screen? Or letter D, flashlight? 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kung ang sagot mo ay D or flashlight, ikaw ay mahusay. Congratulations! Naitulay mo ang pagsagot ng ating assessment para sa lesson na ito. Thank you very much, Science 10 learners, teachers, and enthusiasts. Again, this is your tutor, Ichad, from Katmon Integrated School, Schools Division Office of Malabon City. I am inviting you all to like, share, and subscribe to our DepEd TV official YouTube channel. Magkita-kita tayong muli next week sa panibagong Ag-Amazing at Scitastic Science 10 Itulay Session sa quarter na ito. Paalam at hanggang sa muli!